the city of Osoyoos in the Okanagan Desert, the only semi-arid shrubland in Canada. Are you guys joining us on the desert adventure? Please subscribe!
After many hours on the road, we are here in the city of Osoyoos.
Let's go explore!
But don't forget to watch out for snakes! This is the antelope brush.
It is one of the tallest plants in this ecosystem and can grow more than 3 meters high. The antelope brush is one of Canada's rarest and most endangered habitats. An antelope brush has something in common with an iceberg. Just like majority of an iceberg's mass is located below the surface, antelope brush's roots stretching below the surface of the ground. These long roots help it survive by absorbing moisture deep beneath the surface. Osoyoos has a unique desert habitat. It is home to many desert animals like burrowing owls, tiger salamanders, and sage grouse. It is 8:30 in the morning and the sun is really strong. It is an environment where daytime temperatures can soar. Although an incredible variety of species live here, we are not seeing any animals yet. Most animals are resting during the day and more active at night. But wait, I see something.
What do you see?
It is a rabbit. Nuttles, Cottontail are the smallest rabbits in British Columbia.
Look what we found. Mini cacti.
So cool. This is a thumb-sized cactus called prickly pear. Prickly pear is the Okanagan's only native cactus species. These cacti love to travel by getting free rides. These hitchhikers attach themselves to animals and people's shoes and travel with them. If you brush up against it, a segment of the cactus will often break off and attach itself to your shoe. Eventually, it falls to the ground and sets down roots and starts growing.
Well, look who rode on our shoes back home with us. A mini cacti. Let's try to plant him in the pot.
We have a pot and soil. Now let's plant him and see if he survives.
Let me just make a hole for him. For him.
Eek, that's huge. There, we planted the cactus. Now let's hope our thumb-sized friend will survive.
Look, there are lots of burrows in the desert. Many of the desert wildlife like to dig. Some dig to protect themselves and survive in the desert. Others dig to catch prey. Did you know that badgers are the best digging animal in the world? They can dig a complex network of burrows with their strong forearms and huge claws. They dig to catch prey or to create shelter.
What's next you can find in the desert?
A rattlesnake!
Do you know, guys, what makes a rattlesnake rattle? When threatened, a rattlesnake will vibrate its tail as a warning. The distinctive noise it makes is caused by segments in the tail knocking against each other. So, if one rattles at you, slowly back away. Rattlesnakes prefer to retreat when faced with people.
Hi! How are you doing, subscribers? Did you remember to subscribe?
Look what we found!
Let's go!
What is a desert? A place that receives less than 25 centimeters or 10 inches of rain per year is considered a desert.
So what do experts say about the Okanagan Desert?
Experts say there's too much precipitation, so it's not a true desert, but
it definitely felt like a desert.
Well, as we learned, it's not a true desert, but it definitely felt like one.
It was so hot there.
Though we were lucky to see some very special desert animals. Thank you for watching and joining us on the adventure. Bye!
Did you remember to subscribe?